In this video, I will show you how to allow and configure auto-forwarder to an external email address in Microsoft 365. We will see here, what is an auto-forwarder? How to allow auto-forwarding in Microsoft 365? And how to configure auto-forwarder in Outlook Online and also in the Microsoft 365 Admin Center. So let's get started and see what an auto-forwarder or just a forwarder is. It is an automatic action that sends or forward any email that is received by the recipient to another email address. It could be an external email address or an email address within the same organization or domain name. You may find this type of requirements, for example, when the users want to receive their work's emails in their personal email address. In this case, the business may want to prohibit this kind of action, but it is not the subject of this video. You need to know that by default, Microsoft 365 does not allow to configure auto-forwarders to any external email address. However, you can still configure auto-forwarders to another email address within the same organization or domain name. The auto-forwarder to an external email address can be configured by the user or by the administrator. However, in both cases, it has to be enabled by the administrator before it can work. If the forwarder is configured but not enabled by the administrator, the sender of an email will receive a bounce back, indicating that there was a problem. So let's see how the administrator can enable to allow the auto-forwarding within the Microsoft 365 Admin Center. To access the Admin Center, we will open the browser and we can go to login.microsoftonline.com. We can also use portal.office.com. We enter our username and our password and click on sign in. We are being asked if we want to reduce the number of times to ask for sign in. We will say no because this is a test account. On the left, we will find the admin icon, which will give us access to the Microsoft 365 Admin Center. Then we can click on the three little dashes to expand the menu. And then click on Show All. If we scroll down a little bit, we will find Security. And it will take us to Microsoft 365 Defender. Scrolling down a little bit, we will find the option Policies and Rules. We click on there. On the right, we need to click on Threat Policies. Under Policies, we need to click on Anti-Spam. And then we need to open Anti-Spam Outbound Policy. It will open on the right, and we can scroll down, and we need to click on Edit Protection Settings. By the way, here we will find Automatic Forwarding, which is the policy that we want to change. It is currently set to Automatic, System Controlled. So let's click on Edit Protection Settings. We will find Forwarding Rules. By clicking here, it will expand. I will give you the available options. The one that we need to select is On, Forwarding is Enabled. Then we need to click on Save. We will get this message here, Security, your organization settings need to be updated. Do you want to continue? We will click on Yes. And it is now saving the policy. The anti-spam outbound policy has been saved and is now updated. If we scroll down and we look at automatic forwarding, we will see that it is on. Forwarding is enabled. So we can click on close. The auto forwarding is now enabled and it can work now. Of course, after configuring by the user or by the administrator. Now, let's see how you as the administrator can configure it. This configuration only allows to forward to a single email address. If you as the administrator want to configure auto forwarder to multiple email addresses, then you will need to use email rules in Exchange Online. This might be a subject for another video. So we need to go back to the Admin Center and we need to click on Users, Active Users. So we need to select the user we want to configure the auto-forwarding. We click on the user. On the right, we need to click on the Mail tab right here. And we will find here email forwarding. We will click on Manage Email Forwarding and we select the option forward all emails sent to this mailbox. Below, you will need to enter the email address where we want to forward all the emails. This could be an internal email address, I mean under the same domain name, or it could be an external email address, for example, a Gmail. We enter our Gmail address, for example, and we will find this additional option. Keep a copy of forwarded emails in this mailbox. In this case, we want to keep a copy in our mailbox, so we leave it selected. Then we click on Save Changes. As we can see here, mailbox email forwarding info is updated. Now, if the user wants to update or set up their own forwarder, he can access Outlook on the web or Outlook online. Let's see how it can be done. As the user, we need to click on Outlook. We will be accessing Outlook online, and we will need to click on Settings on the upper right corner on the little wheel. Then at the bottom, we will find View All Outlook Settings. On the left, we will find Forwarding. We click on it. We can see here, this is the email forwarder that was set up by the administrator. The user can change this just by editing the email address that is here. And we will see the same options that the administrator had. As an example, we are going to change this email address. And then we click on Save. As an alternative, the user can also configure the auto-forwarder in Outlook on their desktop. In that case, the user will need to use the email rules. Once the auto-forwarder has been enabled and configured, all the emails will be automatically forwarded to the email address that was set up. The auto-forwarder can be a useful tool for users and also for the administrator. However, keep in mind that it also could be a feature that you want to keep disabled depending on the policies of the organization. I hope you find value in this video. If you do, please give us a thumbs up. If you have any question or comment, please leave it here down below. And if you want to see more videos like this one, or want to find it easy again in the future, please hit the subscribe button. Thank you, and I hope to see you next time.